sometimes the times of our lives, going to nightclubs, dancing till dawn, drinking champagne and snorting cocaine. Shit, fuck, crap. Those weren't the good times, those were the high times. It just seemed like the good times because we were young and fabulous and behind the velvet rope. Now we're old and tired and couldn't give a shit about hot clubs, VIP rooms, or the party of the year. The days of area are over. Thank you, Eric Good. I hope that turtle sanctuary in Ojai is working out for you. We'd slink out of the back of a taxi in stilettos and shoulder pads and hair teased into a frothy concoction that defied the night and said, we're here and we're hot. By the time our heels hit the curb, the doorman had unlatched the velvet rope and we were in. A couple of entry tickets slipped into our hands. We strutted down the hallway towards the flashing lights and the thumping music. We did a round of the club from the front dance floor through the unisex bathrooms to the quiet room in the back. A shark tank in the floor, a pygmy on the bar. Annie waved. It was Reuben with Mickey and Osha. Mickey wore a long plaid skirt he had made himself with the customary black leather jacket and Doc Martens. He was fabulous. They were fabulous. We all were. A drink appears in my hand and greetings all around. We hadn't seen each other since last night, Wednesday night, at the Cat Club where Billy Idol's girlfriend had a floor show. Punk ballet. I'd met him before. Billy Idol. We used the same dealer. At a hair salon in Alphabet City. The Coke dealers were all hairdressers from Peru. They'd make you look great and feel great. Bad-mowing hairspray and Peruvian pink flake. Tito was there, kissing Annie and me. He nodded his head in the direction of the bathroom, a Pied Piper of sorts as we trotted after him in obedient anticipation, bypassing the line of wannabes. We went into a stall, Tito, Annie, Mickey, Osha, me. Reuben stayed behind. He had his own supply. Tito pulled out the usual brown glass vial, only his had a silver cover of entwined leaves, a silver spoon, bumps all around, one nostril at a time, and then again. Outside there was a crash, swearing and shock. We opened the stall door. A woman was face down on the floor, her skirt hiked up above her waist. A man lay on top of her, his pants pulled down and his hard cock pressed against her bare butt. He had a blowtorch in one hand and a crack pipe in the other. Osha said, they should have locked the stall door. We couldn't hide our laughter. Why would we? The jaded crowd went back to their cocktails and chatter. We stepped over the couple in mid-fuck to get back to the party. We passed that guy with the parrot. The pygmy walked by. I guess he was on break from working the bar. His clay mask was off and he was smoking a joint. Electronic new wave pelted us. How does it feel to treat me like you do? Blue Monday. Let's dance. I couldn't feel my feet. High times, good times, I'll sleep when I'm dead times. It was the times before we realized that coke was addictive and treatment was somewhere you went, not something you got at the spa. The times before people were dying of some disease that ravaged the West Village and the nightclubs and the theaters, that someone said had come from Ibiza where the Euro trash partied, that someone else said was simian, the plague that decimated the city. We didn't know what HIV was, only that people were dying, people we knew, people we loved.